be the favorite by quite a bit in this series.
Yeah, even though you think RNG may be, you know, more distinguished lineup at the moment.
At the moment.
Aster, their lineup seems, it's tankier, seems easy to do. Seems pretty decent as well.
Yeah, they like the silencer pick.
Yeah.
And I do like the silencer pick here.
I like it as well, actually. I mean, they're going to go up against the DPK, which is just a little bit extra, which makes you get an attack every time it hits.
Counter rotation will be scouted, though, by the Shadow Boy.
Oh, that's...
There is no good limbs, but look at this. They've actually got the silencer as well. Boca, that's trying to get a little bit more damage in. Thunderstrike's waiting for him, though, and, well, an even angrier Storm as well. But RNG, actually, they need two heroes around TP out. They do have the Flame Remnants at the ready. Cuts the tree, looking to scout him out. They've scouted him, though. Setsu instead is going to go for the easy, guaranteed kill onto the Boca. Gets off the last sword at the very least. There's the rotation from the Storm Spirit. Jumped onto the back line. Shadow Demon having already used disruption. He will go down, but look at that, Setsu in some trouble, gets the Remnant off, and the Sleight of Fist dodge out the damage. Chuan, he's gonna be waiting for his brother, but he took the other bus home that time, and not gonna be waiting for him there.
Yeah, I mean, decent rotation, you have to bring sort of all of Aster down here. Good space made by RNG.
Yeah.
It's only traded one for one, I think.
And they've got Monet farming pretty freely up in the top lane, but a big silence on the Undersphere. He might be in some trouble. Ursa Warrior coming into party. A Setsu will go down, getting a little bit too...
Yeah, that was, you know,
you got out once, you know. Yeah. Be happy with that.
Yeah, sure. I'll just hang out here.
Here I am! X here now is making the jump forward. Smoke is breaking by Kwan. He's just gonna go. Oh, nice glimpse. Who's they call it? Oh, it's just an A. They don't need the ulti for him. Level 7 here on our Disruptor, committing an ultimate, however, in return will be our AA. So there's gonna be Demonic Purge drop. The move speed overridden. Global Silence committed here as Boca on the run will be caught, cut off, rather, by Monet. A lot of pings. Is there an Ice Blast thing coming? There might be. Take a look here in just a second as Flywound will now show up on the map. There's going to be the jump. They really want to go for this kill. Diving the tier 2 tower. Oh, the ult is going to get canceled though by the Static Storm. Is Ursa Warrior jumping in for that? They've given the torch. They've Noven rather the tier 2 tower now.
Left him back actually.
Oh, that might be the glimpse. We'll hold him down. And in the Ice Blast, he goes for S-triple-C. As now Setsu rotating over. Like he TP'd over to the outpost, getting damage. And the Syrian champions onto FaZe who will be chopped down. Jumping out immediately onto S-triple-C. Continuing to try and find him. We do still have the Enrage. He's going to turn now with Silencer ulti. There's no point in the overpower for S-triple-C. He gets the Blade Mall off. Oh my goodness, he's barely alive. But S-triple-C able to out-tank him there with the damage reduction of the ulti. I'm sure making a difference. Good turn, but there's no like hoof stop right there. They will get a kill on Silencer. Again, that's just Setsu getting solo kills. Nothing to see there. Smoke will break. Oh, looking for the disruption. S-triple-C diving out into the trees. Dragon Tail stun there onto the Centaurs. In comes the Roll. Laying down the Ice Blast. They have committed the Static Storm, though. Onto the Disruptor, as they have killed the AA. Now coming into a Dragon Tail, though, will be our AA. Stunned up for quite a long time, as well as disarmed by the Lucky Shot. Can't get any of this bonus damage, and finally the Overloads will be coming through. Ursa Warrior with the Enrage, looking to get the damage onto Monet. Will be able to do so, but jumping in, it will be set to send him right back with the Glimpse. I thought he died with the Sleight of Fist, but no, he's got to run it down anyway. He jumps in versus 3. They don't actually engage HP pool to kill him. Setsu is very that going to dive now under the Tier 2. Electric Vortex, will that end making the difference? It's gonna get the kill onto the Storm Spirit. Setsu, last word of play, he has no more Remnant to throw down, and he's gonna be quite heavy for that dive. He's gonna get the mid laner, but that's another plus 2 and over to him.
Setsu in this game, I feel like that's...
As well as Silencer, if they're really bothering you that much, although probably for the Storm preventing the overload. So they have scouted him. Static Storm, the Glimpse actually pushes him further away. Into the two-man stomp, though, but it's not enough fault. Vex just forced to back off, so they're going to pop the Elder Dragon form. Looking to find, there's no global up, so Silencer, Boca, he's just responding to die. Setsu bring him down. That means Setsu's not here, and the Ursa Warrior running rampant, not running even faster with the Stampede, trying to run away, but caught by the Static Field. The Static Field rather will be the Shadow Demon as they continue running down the course here. Flywind, he's gonna smash Velcro in a second, but won't get the chance to use it. S-triple-C now with the double kill. As it's Setsu returning to at least get an equivalent onto Dyer's the enemy offlaner. And we'll see. Can't really fight this. DK nearby. The Enrage is not available. The disarm only for a few seconds, but that will be enough. And a triple kill for Setsu.
Right.
It's a weird one, right? It's a weird one.
The Disruptor, we seem to, like, he doesn't have any, he's almost got the same amount of HP, but,
Oh, wow. Yeah, they're making the Setsu.
They
didn't want to commit for it. Trying to scout with the Glimpse. Oh, there's going to be September making the jump against Dana Lyon. Not things on him first. He's got half HP, but they will be able to pull back one.
Oh, the Global.
Hold up, is the Storm Spirit. Ooh, he does not get the zip out. I think they got him just in time. to die to the Ice Blast. Setsuga gets the kill below. We've got the Static Storm. He'll be dropped now onto two, but where's the follow-up? It's going to be the Hoof Stomp now. As, I'm not sure if they really have anything else. We'll see, but with the BKB jumping in, can he get the kill here? Onto Setsu. Disarm, though, as the BKB will eventually wear off. You cannot dispel that Stampede, but I guess they wanted to maybe just continue poking and prodding.
It's just gonna be tough.
And I need a Disruptor X, which isn't cute yet. He's gonna be going for a Yule Scepter of his own. And now he's picking up a Haste Strip. It's a very fast dragon now. It's disarmed the Sentinel Conqueror, just standing still. There's the stop, though. Global Silence. They committed the Static Storm here again.
Tanky guy, jump on.
RDK. Storm Spirit now zipping in. Can he get a kill here onto a BKB? Now pop by Mission Team, but they have dropped him on the Persian. Oh, fantastic. Rolling Thunder. It's a Stampede. Unable to save our Storm Spirit. He will die. Finally, they get the DK. But now my Setsu's still here, rolling around and causing the pain. Is gonna be flying when setting up for two more kills. The Rolling Thunder finally ending with the pain just beginning to come down here as Asper will lose four heroes all in an effort to pick up the DK.
What? I mean,
we'll see how Team Master try and recover this now. It was RNG to make the SCA smoke. We just fought them. Let's fight them again. The last thing they suspect going for the D word will be our poor silencers. For more, rooted up and extra silence for the last word, but a nice dual scepter by time into the clumsy net. Post stomp will connect. Vex has us in a bit of trouble. Ice Blast coming in. The only thunder to follow through. Plenty of damage for that target. Nice two picks. That could open up Roach, but I think
he goes for Kaya first and Orchid. There's nothing wrong with that, but this game, you either get Orchid early or I really got busted. So I thought I suck.
Nine charges too, that's brutal.
So it feels like that's just okay damage. Just okay, but yeah. It's not instant lock.
Well, speaking of instant lockdown, there they go. Global Science Storm once again. She's going to get the DK in here. Did not get off the older Dragon Form, but again, they lack the damage. So he will be able to get the Dragon Tail.
I mean, sorry, Aegis.
No, he does have Aegis, you're right. Now, Shadow Demon looking for a disruption. Diving the tier 2 tower. He will go down. Poor positioning. The triple T pop in the Aegis. Now, getting rage. Gets bashed there onto Sets. And can the damage through in time to get the play mall off. But it will be the CK getting control. Over surrounded by three heroes. And Sets who chipping away to safety. Buyback will be triggered by RNG. I think all these are a good energy, at least the siege. Oh no, the siege is actually still alive.
Oh, it's got that new balance thing. Oh, there you go.
Jumping. BKB committed here for the first life. Big ice blast to the global line. Taking that ineffective static storm now to try and control the tank loop. But they do have the damage charm at the very least. You saw the Shukka standing inside the static storm with Setsu now finally free. The stampede will be committed. SMC rocking for his life, but the stop just a second late. It's going to be Astral Z dying on his high ground. Global Silence already committed. The silencer will be getting ran down now by Setsu. And Boboka's a little bit tempted here, surprisingly. Storm Spirit able to find a kill there in the meantime. It's 1v4.
It's a really tough game for Aster at this point. Well, almost impossible game to beat.
Yeah. It's only a 11-point difference, actually. 23-26. It's still pretty close. Has that Aegis been reclaimed? It's looking like it's getting there. It has indeed in that way.
The thing is that Aster got a lot of their kills. They were like 5-1 beginning, so a lot of their gold they came like early game. They didn't get all these kills on RNG, so the last 10 minutes most of the RNG game kills.
Yep. I'm there with the Syrian Chains, unable to do so. His brother proving to be too elusive.
That's right, but I'm going to assume it's reduced.
Boboka though, gonna be caught. He's sitting here. Oh, there's the Abyssal. That's a black dragon. Actually, the Global Silence will come through now. But the Ag Scepter trying to get the damage here. The Triple C and the beautiful Rolling Thunder keeping him locked down. Looks like Storm Spirit fighting the AA. Will be able to get a kill on save at the very least. BKB now with that 10 second duration now turning and it's dying. They will be able to drop that. The Static Storm at least onto two heroes. Not the last long enough. Schwan now. BKB has ended. He will go down. Okay, we're going to be too tanky, and the GG will be called Ultra Overfly win as RNG spun up, and they take a really nice fight, utilizing that terrain perfectly. The odds were against them, and this time, maybe fortune in their favor.
I know, you have the Oracle, fortune.
That was actually completely off the cuff. I didn't even plan to do that. I forgot they had the Oracle, but it's like my passive. Unless you hit me with a silver, which I'm always going to be throwing puns your way. We have the horn. Perfect timing.
But damage. The thing is, Ember's the damage it has no value. You cannot get any magic damage, but the actual harass is it's decent.
It's good. It helps you last as well. Push it way out so you can just go stack your jungle.
Oh, oh, he's walking in this.
Big damage as they drop the bar right down. Look at that. That's going to be a kill. You cannot underestimate the ankle gun here as FaZe going to continue running him down. That's going to be a ton of damage onto him as well. As the double kill now onto FaZe. It's Triple C hitting him with a flux, I believe. It's obviously you're going to get murdered by Tideburn over and over again. So he's back to Flame Grove. He runs and he nukes all the creeps and he goes and farms jungle for another 30 seconds. So I wonder if that actually helps him farm faster. A lot of us, Triple C. Trouble. Sharp being the mark, the stomp, the snowball in time, as they will be able to put him down. The Puka has rotated from the lane, but my goodness, the healing kill did put the fly win there, as they will get one in return onto the Tusk. Goodness, running down and that proved to be a very dangerous expedition.
Is
I'm a racer, phase boots.
Well, we do have him, but the player right here. You go.
There's, yeah, but they're looking for him. Twomplex already here. He says, "Hello, sir. How are you doing?" There's going to be, I believe, the stampede committed. Going now onto the refly went drop. All hell, they look at the damage coming through the Reaper Titan now to try and turn around. Monet's staying alive for just a little bit longer. Got the balance strike, but he's going down. Twomplex got the deal to him as it's only Fade that drop after. And
Arc Ward, then he's going to go for that Maelstrom. So that means that you kind of want to ask you see though.
Yeah, there's going to be the down onto him. That's the real, and you can be sure of that. The bubble will be placed down, but it's not going to save you for dark damage. Possibly able to turn it around here. A nice three-man stomp, but it's not going to be. If you go in actually not the Radiant, but for the Hand of Midas, no, it's going to be the Maelstrom. Triple rate fan to the boots with all the going to flow out of the next one. And that's spread out from the damage increase. They're trying to turn it around, and actually, they've committed even the Chain Frost there just to make sure that Oracle does not get the ulti out. He will be next fall. He's going to ulti himself. They might be able to turn this into more as Monet rotating in from the mid lane. He's going to have the Jingu, the ulti available. Going to get the kill onto the Lich. His Fade will die to Super. The ulti later now.
I like the Vessel. Again, you are up against an Oracle. Oh, SCC, no. No, SCC, not like this.
That's the real one, too, here. Oh, gives him a little runaround with the Chingis. Maybe buying enough spears. The stomp will not connect onto Setsu now. Trying to keep him alive, but the X-Marks to pull him right back into the Wukong's command. As they actually get a kill onto the Lich as well. I think he got it with the cleave. Didn't
go past the
ult. Stampede, maybe looking for a kill on the fly. That's a tough kill. Again, they always really love going for the hard kick, but at least they have the damage for it this time. The kill onto him. Okay. Maybe you're now in some trouble. As the Centaur getting the wall response. XSS will put now with the X-Arch. There's the Lich. A pretty good one with the Seer and Chains now. They might be able to turn this into a little bit more. Have a bounce. Why don't you super Odin? Wave it about. He gets a second one actually in between the group, but just get the ulti off on the Monet. He's dropped by five. He's going to go down. Faster. Now they're looking for more. They want to maybe find Setsu, but
he's what called mantle intelligence?
That's okay. You also see that ET carries briefcases.
I see exactly what's about to make. Thank you.
We'll see. They found the real one. You hear the X marks onto the Lich. Nice stomp though in return. The ET stomp though as the ulti will come out. There's too many creep here trying to split some tempo though, unless he gets unlucky. Maybe the creep will be rolling in just in time. But Aster will lose two of their ultis there on the supports, and they might lose a bit more. ET in some trouble. The X-Marks to bring him right back over. Pokemon shaking his head as the Stampede will come out. Oh, nice stomp though. Setsu is quite low here. They just no longer have that rumble. Gonna bring him over to the creep wave. The Jingu Mastery though trying to turn this around. Oh, onto the back. Schwan taking the jump, but they don't have the little ulti. This time XSS, he will go down. Schwan in some trouble as the Trip C trying to get damage in. They've actually lost Schwan as well. Jumping around the fight, he's
using you can apply the deep multiple heroes. But I mean, you're gonna be vesseled. Yeah. Oh no, sorry, not vesseled. There's like a lot of, but the Yulta can dodge a lot of things, and can't do that with this.
Yeah, but
you know, not all like the X Lock. You have to dodge, gives you one more method. To
nice giant. He hopes that you're gonna get off the stunt, but he will not. Rosh will fall.
And especially if you get the talent for it. I believe it's effective.
Of course.
You get the bigger
one. Oh, that's the real one. That's in some trouble. Chop the bubble here. Trying to get out of harm's way, but the boat will find it.
Next round, 40 gold.
He's good. Eventually, we'll decide. They've had enough. But bottom, they are fighting here. The Oracle keeping alive the Necro. I bet he's gonna hop out fully to be here as Luke will get ran down into the Reaper's side. Thank you very much for your life. But Boca's Courier can kill as well, which is You're dead for a full minute as a support. What is he, like, level 8 at this point? And he's dead for a minute? That's off.
Kripos takes no hostage, man. That's just so bad.
No prisoners. I don't think RNG takes no prisoners here. It's the Boundless Strike completing a second kill here.
It was more fun when Necrophos damage can do.
All right, here we go. Aster going to try and take a fight outside of the base, but that's not going to be the target to come on. They recognize that. They go up the Oracle instead. He's going to be able to cut the ulti on himself. He will. The Boundless Strike now onto 2. As they're going to be in the BKB one. A various Earth is splitter offer. Might be able to turn this fight. The Lich ulti bouncing around. Not very much, but Oracle still on a full HP. We've used BKBs all around. Ishwan trying to be able to escape here. Luckily, he finds a moment to breathe and a regeneration rune. It's like a mirage. A mirage, a visage, is it? What's the word in the desert?
Mirage, yeah.
Mirage, yeah.
Thank you.
Not like a visage.
Visage is the hero.
Visage is the hero.
What the playing. Hell?
Very nice. X marks. They're trying to lock him down. Up to the high ground he goes, but they've got a ward, and they know exactly where he is. Dead for 75.
That's a rough one. That's a rough one. I mean, it actually
about buyback here. Actually, about buyback is Ember Spirit. He's gonna do a good with the bubbles on the back lines, trying to be able to blow up Super here once again. Lich, Sinister Gaze, keeping the team in the cleave. S3C has awoken them here with the Maelstrom Prox as the BKB now by Setsu. Actually, now Boundless Strike's still gonna catch him there in the Wukong side, but S3C continuing to fight now as he's gotten good damage in, but the sustain is gonna be a little bit too high coming through. Faith Edict will be blocking all of the Lightning Procs. And they're just as healthy as ever, ready to go high ground. You can actually apparently proc like the end of Rocky 2 where the Russian guy's beating him up.
Rocky 4?
He gets beat up in all of them, honestly.
Oh, that's good.
It's like the end of insert Rocky movie here. They're gonna be able to try and give it the ball. There's gonna be the ults coming through. Good, decent damage as they will commit the Lich Chain Procs now. Boundless Strike, however, will be slowing down support strong. BKB, he is not gonna be a good ulti, actually. Getting a lot of damage, forced back off a bit. This is Stampede, the fear of the Oracle. Gonna be placing the ulti there on the flyway. He's got him. Oracle at least will fly for them. Damage on the flyway, unbelievable. He still pops out. He's still got health. He wants to stand for him. He leaves. He just TPs.
Spice
in the pit.
They're pinging into here.
RNG, up 18k. Perfect the smoke. The blink, maybe not at the ready. Oh, they keep him alive. The necromancy committed, but the boundless strike won't put him down.
Lich buys back.
Yeah, it's gonna be bouncing around here. BKB committed.
The
Chile the Arbol is very spicy pepper, which it's actually modeled after in game. Four stab, not nice from Flywings. He's gonna get the ulti off. Very nice stop. Will stop September in his tracks. Surrounded here by 5. The Earth Splitter does a good amount of damage. Lich ulti will get the boat. Oh, look at the damage onto ET. The Stampede not coming up in time. They're gonna try and map time this with Setsu. He's got way too much damage. That Triple T has fallen dead for 70. There's gonna be the Boundless Strike to put down.
You were the center. Champion of your arena. Two
heroes,
well,
3 heroes fallen there for Aster. They fight a choke.
So, like, look at the thing. He actually got, like, the two-man in the splitter. Pretty
with
good.
Because he got a really good sleep there, but your procs are asleep.
Oh, yeah. Right?
So you're going to wake up this September immediately after. Or anyone else who's there.
I mean, it just, it feels like it's been slow to fast for like this
really
entire game, you know?
10 to 24, 20, was that 7? That is 7, 27k net worth lead. A nice stomp here, we'll slow them down. Maybe give them one last team fight here for the boys, but Team Aster, they're about to drop the big lives. It's 0 to 4, trying to keep the last barracks alive. As they might be able to do so here, trying to force them back in here. Damage though, Lightning Procs, getting very low HP here on Monet, but they will finish off the last pair of barracks. Maybe they actually had, they got some bombs. Oh my goodness, goodbye. Centaur getting absolutely deleted. The first life on Monet, now they're gonna get burned. There's gonna be the ulti in time, the ulti getting dropped. They have got Kunkka through his BKB as well. Good damage here to fly away to September, back onto the high ground. Monet will be triggering the ulti here. BKB on his first life, coming out of the ulti, he will be healthy enough to kill Lich. That's no problem. Gem now on the deck, coming out of the ulti here. Finding S3C, finds the bash onto him. And Aster are melting in their base. The GG will be called RNG, claiming the 2-0 victory in this series.
That's a bit of an unfortunate end, honestly. It feels like game one, Aster had a bit more spirit in them, and then this game comes around. The draft is, you know, it's a tough draft to have Ember Spirit against the Kunkka. Kunkka just was able to get great rotations. And, I mean, we saw Sentai both games have kind of minimal impact, in my opinion. So.